Tejinderpal Singh Toor clinched the men's shot put gold with a record-shattering throw to open India's medal account in athletics in Asian Games on Saturday. The 23-year-old threw the iron ball to 20.75 meters to win the gold medal and set a national record as well. He bettered the 6-year-old record of 20.69 meters in the name of Om Prakash Karhana. Congress President Rahul Gandhi has described the 1984 anti-Sikh riots as a very painful tragedy and said that he was 100% for the punishment for those involved in any violence against anybody. Nearly 3,000 Sikhs were killed in the riots in 1984 following the assassination of former Prime Minister Indira Gandhi by her Sikh bodyguards when the Congress government was in power at the centre. Mr. Gandhi, who is on a two-day visit to the UK, told the audience of UK-based parliamentarians and local leaders on Friday that the incident was a tragedy and painful experience, but disagreed with the view that the Congress was involved. The Shiromani Akali Dal on Saturday hit out at Congress President Rahul Gandhi over his remarks on the 1984 anti-Sikh riots, saying that by disagreeing with the view that his party was involved in the genocide, he had rubbed salt into the wounds of Sikh community. Hitting out at the Congress President, SAD Chief Sukhbir Singh Badal alleged that Mr. Gandhi was trying to protect those Congress leaders who were involved in the genocide. Ahead of the upcoming 2+2 talks with the US, the Defense Acquisition Council that met on Saturday cleared the procurement of 24 multi-role helicopters for the Navy. In all, the DAC gave approvals for procurement deals worth approximately 46,000 crores. In another decision, DAC gave the formal approval for procurement of 111 naval utility helicopters at a cost of over 21,000 crores. Stepping up attack on the government over the Rafale fighter jet issue, senior Congress leader P. Chidambaram on Saturday accused the centre of ignoring the defence procurement procedure and bypassing several committees to secure the deal. The former finance minister also alleged the Cabinet Committee on Security was not taken into confidence by the government before signing the deal. The trade between India and China at the Nathula border dropped by 90% in 2017 owing to the standoff at Doklam between the two countries. According to figures provided by the Department of Commerce and Industries, Government of Sikkim, the value of exports from India to China in 2016 was 63.38 crores and the import from China was 19.3 crores. The government on Saturday appointed eminent scientist Dr. G. Satish Reddy as the chairman of Defence Research and Development Organisation. The top post of DRDO had been vacant since May after the then chief Dr. S. Christopher stepped down. Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Saturday expressed hope that the festival of Onam will give new strength to the people of Kerala to overcome the adversities in the aftermath of the floods. He said that the country is behind the people of the state. According to government sources, the government will soon increase the honorarium awarded to Anganwadi workers following a proposal from the Ministry of Women and Child Development. The Expenditure Finance Committee under the Ministry of Finance on Friday approved a proposal from the Ministry of Women and Child Development to hike the honorarium. In a major effort to improve emergency medical support to soldiers posted in high-altitude areas, especially Siachen, the Integrated Defence Staff of Defence Ministry and ISRO signed a Memorandum of Understanding on Friday to set up telemedicine nodes in critical places across the country. ISRO will establish 53 more nodes in the first phase over and above the existing 20 in various establishments of Army, Navy and Air Force across the country.